Gary was one of the good guys, you know?
He lived in Connecticut?
Yeah. And then he had to get sucked into this.
Sucked into what?
Gary was just visiting.
Mom, come on.
He was, Hugh.
You know what you're doing is disrespectful to Gary's memory, to who he was as a person?
What are we talking about?
Gary was in town on account of our younger brother, Eric.
Who is fundamentally a good person.
He's a criminal.
He is a decent person who is struggling with the same things your father struggled with.
Dad wasn't a junkie, Mom.
Neither is your brother.
All right, enough.
Sorry. Just overwrought.
So what do you think your brother Eric has to do with Gary getting killed?
Gary came into town to basically do an intervention on Eric.
To me, it seemed very presumptuous.
That's because you still see him as 5 years old.
Okay, guys.
Gary was going to see Eric this morning about his drinking, his drugs, and basically his overall nasty behavior toward the family and Mom. Now, I'm not saying that Eric had something to do with Gary's death, but the people Eric keeps company with, lowlifes.
PFC's Jenkins and Rodriguez put you at Nagata's the night of the rape. Is this true, Corporal Reynolds?
Yes, sir.
What were you doing there?
They taped the Yankee games for us, sir.
You drinking that night?
Yes, sir.
You looking to get some?
No, sir.
You nervous, Corporal?
A little, sir.
Why? Did you rape that girl?
No, sir.
You protecting the person who did?
No, sir.
Then you got nothing to be nervous about. So, who won?
Excuse me, sir?
The night that girl was forced to have intercourse against her will, who won the game?
Well, Mr. Degenerate, I see you managed to put on another fiasco tonight.
You know, Miller, you're the only white guy I know with a brown nose.
Very good. Laugh it up, funny man. But you lost another sponsor tonight. And Mr. Spencer just downed a year's supply of Prozac. He wants to see you in his office. Now.
Yes, he died in the hospital. He'd been in our residential treatment program for the past 6 months.
Someone saw Mr. Abbott abducted in New Market Square yesterday.
Abducted? Thrown into the van by two men?
You mean he actually was?
No, he snuck out after breakfast.
He was mentally ill.
Schizoaffective disorder. He'd been having manic symptoms with psychotic delusions for over a week.
Delusions that somebody wanted his numbers?
Exactly. His numbers, or his equation, or his formula. He was a physics professor at MIT, but he'd been fighting mental illness his whole life. His son Noel had him placed with us against his father's wishes.
So what happened when you found him?
He calmed down. He fell asleep as soon as he was back. But I guess being outside must have been very stressful for him. Incredibly taxing on his heart.
You could have sent him into anaphylactic shock.
Missed it, sorry.
Sorry is for when you show up to work a zombie. Sorry is for when you borrow thousands of dollars and never pay back.
Spare me the lecture.
But sorry doesn't cover nearly killing a patient because you're so distracted and tired that all you think about is gambling.
I worked two shifts.
Stop lying.
What the hell is this?
End of the line, Grant. You coming with me?
Eddie, don't say anything.
Where were you in all this?
Lloyd drives in front of us. It was just me and Monty on the bus.
Shut up, Eddie. Monty's lawyer says that we don't have to talk to anybody until he gets here.
He has nothing to worry about. No one's under arrest.
We owe Monty a lot, okay? The guy's been really good to us, and we knew that none of us killed her.
Well, if you let her off the bus in the middle of nowhere in that condition, you may as well have.
Look, when Eddie told me where she got off the bus, I went back there and looked for her. I must have driven that road for an hour. I figured she hitched a ride back.
He figured.
Maybe Monty made a bad call in letting the girl off, but she wanted off. So he was just doing what she asked.
Except for the sex part.
You know what? You can't prove that.
Yeah, I wouldn't bet against her. So, is Monty still in his office?
No. He had an appointment back at the Iguana Club up in Maryland.
Okay.